हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू डीएवी मॉल पब्लिक स्कूल सीता सावंगी। लेट्स बिगिन आवर टुडेज ई लर्निंग ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स स्टैंडर्ड 10th विथ योर टीचर मिसेस वंदना घाघरे। टुडे इन द लेसन पॉलिनोमियल्स वी विल सी द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन जीरोज ऑफ पॉलिनोमियल्स एंड कोएफिशिएंट्स ऑफ अ पॉलिनोमियल। See here a quadratic polynomial, but before that, are you aware what are the zeros and the coefficients of the polynomial? Zeros are nothing but the value of x. As it is a quadratic polynomial, we will get two values of x because the degree is 2. And the coefficient means whatever the numbers are there with the terms x square and x. That terms are known as the coefficients of the polynomial. So in this case, if we will see, first we will find out the factorize actually to find out the zeros of the polynomial. The polynomial is 2x square minus 8x plus 6 equals to splitting the middle term. We are aware this process because in standard 7th, standard 8th, and standard 9th. In all three sections and standards, we have practiced this method. So, now you are the master of finding the factors by splitting the middle term. So, here 2x square minus 8x plus 6 equals to 2 into x minus 1 into x minus 3. So, we have to take to find the zeros of the polynomial. We have to take the polynomial's value as 0 and therefore it becomes x minus 1 equals to 0 or x minus 3 equals to 0 because when we put this then only the quadratic polynomial becomes 0 and therefore x minus 1 equals to 0 means x equals to 1 and x minus 3 equals to 0 means x equals to 3. Now here if we will take the sum of its zeros, so what are the zeros? 1 and 3. So take the sum of its 0 equals to 1 plus 3 equals to 4. And if we will write in terms of the coefficients, so it is minus of minus 8 upon 2. But it is minus 8 is what? See, minus 8 is the coefficient of x. And 2 is the coefficient of x square. So, minus of coefficient of x upon coefficient of x square. This relation we got from the answers. Now, let us take the product of its zeros. 1 into 3 equals to 3. That we will write as 6 divided by 2 is equal to what is 6? Constant term upon what is 2? Coefficient of x square. So again we will get the relation constant term upon coefficient of x square. Here a means the coefficient of x square means the coefficient of x and c we will use for the constant term. So if you will consider this quadratic polynomial, here a is 2, b is minus 8 and c is equal to 6. See here, one more example for you. 3x square plus 5x minus 2. Can you tell me what is A? Yes, A is equal to 3. What is B? Yes, B is equal to 5. And what is C? C is equal to minus 2. We have to take the sign because it is the negative number. Now factorize it. The factors of the polynomial are by splitting the middle term. See here, step wise given. By splitting up the middle term, the factors of the polynomial are 3x minus 1 and 3x, x plus 2. Now, we have to either write 3x minus 1 equals to 0 or x plus 2 equals to 0. Then we will get x equals to 1 by 3. Or x equals to minus 2. So the zeros are 1 upon 3 and minus 2. See here quadratic polynomial means 2 zeros. Now again we will find the sum of its zeros. So we will add it these two zero, 1 upon 3 plus minus 2. It will, if you will solve it, you will get minus 5 upon 3. 5 is the coefficient of x and 3 is the coefficient of x square and negative sign. Product of 0 gives you minus 2 by 3. Minus 2 is the quantum and 3 is the coefficient of x square. So see here, by finding out the 0, we are getting the relation between the coefficients. So in general, now we will write it in the form of the zeros of the polynomial and the coefficient of the polynomial. So let's see. Here the quadratic polynomial is ax square plus bx plus c, and x minus alpha and x minus beta are the two factors. Therefore, alpha and beta are the zeros. Okay, now we will solve this ax square plus bx plus c. See here the three terms are there, three methods are there, three steps are there, but only you have to understand the relation between zeros and its polynomial. Okay, so the relation between the zeros and the polynomial gives you alpha plus beta equals to minus b upon a, and alpha beta equals to c upon a. So what is the relation? Sum of zeros, alpha plus beta equals to minus b upon a, and product of zeros equal to c upon a. So let's solve now the problems which are based on this relationship. Find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial means first we will find out the values of the x and then we will verify the relationship which is just now we have seen. So first we will find out the relationship. Zeros, x square plus 7x plus 10, splitting the middle term, it gives us x plus 2 into x plus 5. So the values of x equals to minus 2 and minus 5. Now here, if you'll consider the coefficient and the zeros, alpha equals to minus 2, first 0, and beta equals to minus 5. Now compare the coefficient. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 7, and C is equal to 10, where A is the coefficient of x square, B is the coefficient of x, and C is the constant term. Now take the sum of zero. Zeros are already obtained, no? So take the sum of zeros. Alpha plus beta equals to, what is alpha? Minus 2. What is beta? Minus 5. Add them, it is minus 7. Equation 1. Just give the numbers. Product of zeros, alpha beta. Minus 2 into minus 5 means 10. Minus minus gets cancel. Give the equation 2. Then take minus b upon a. So minus b is what? B is 7. So minus b becomes minus 7 upon 1. So it becomes minus 7. Give this a number. Then take c by a. C by a, c is what? C there? 10. Upon a is what? 1. So 10 upon 1. So it equals to 10. Now if you compare 1, 2, 3 and 4, you will see alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a. Yes or no? Minus 7, minus 7, both are equal. So alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a, and alpha beta equals to 10, and here c by a equals to also 10. So alpha beta equals to c upon a, and we verified the relation between zeros and coefficient. And therefore, we will write it as alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a, and alpha beta equals to c upon a. See here one more example. We have to find the zeros of the polynomial. Here binomial is given. though it is quadratic, but it is binomial, and we all are aware based on the binomial only one identity is there, and that is a plus b and a minus b, a square minus b square equals to. So we will write this polynomial in the form of x plus root 3 and x minus root 3. These are the factors, and from this we will get x equals to root 3 and x equals to minus root 3. Here 3 is written as root 3 into root 3 that we have studied in the standard 8th, that is square and square root. Now here the zeros are 3 and minus root 3. Take the sum of the 0, it is 0. Now compare with the coefficients. Minus coefficient of x is, x term is missing. So coefficient of x is 0 upon coefficient of x square is 1. So 0 upon 1 means 0. So equal, alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. Now see the product of zeros, it equals to minus 3. Now write down the minus 3 in the form of minus 3 upon 1. Now compare the polynomial, constant term is minus 3 and coefficient of x square is 1. So it is c by a. So alpha beta equals to c by a. See here, this is the different type of question, because here sum and product of the zeros are given and you have to write the quadratic polynomial. Okay, now let us take the, here two methods are there, which one you find easy you can go with that method, no problem. Let's quadratic polynomial be ax square plus bx plus c, and its zeros are alpha and beta. Now sum is given, means alpha plus beta equals to minus 3 is given, and that minus 3 is equal to minus b by a, that we are aware. Now product, alpha beta equals to 2, and that 2 equals to c by a, that also we are aware. So if we will write this minus 3 and 2 in the form of minus b by a and c by a, you will get minus 3 upon 1 and 2 upon 1, means a equals to 1, b is equal to 3 and c is equal to 2, and therefore we will write the quadratic polynomial as x square plus 3x plus 2. Now the alternative method for this, let's write required polynomial is x square minus alpha plus beta x plus alpha beta. This is based on the identity x plus a in the bracket x plus b is equal to x square plus a plus bx plus ab. So here already alpha plus beta is given and alpha beta is given, so only you have to substitute the value. Alpha beta equals to 2 and alpha plus beta equals to minus 3. Now solve this, x square minus minus become plus 3x plus 2. Now check your answers. In both the method you will get the same polynomial. Therefore, which method you will find easy, you get that, no problem dear students. So here is the small assignment for you. You have to find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship between, and then in the second one you, sum and product is zero given, you have to find the quadratic polynomial. Thank you. Have a nice day.